studied also, then I think that my child should also output into them. And they get influenced by those traditions, and they force their kids to take and then end for whatever field they want. They actually don't care as what their child want to be. In this context, I just want to give an example of the movie Three Idiots. You all might agree with me. Their moment Iran virus. The video of the principal of ICE has posed unbeatable pressure for his decision on his child, on his child, to be an engineer. But his son was not able to handle that unbeatable pressure and profit from society. Today, 15 out of 857 students has committed suicide in 2007-2009. 50 were 138 in 2008, and 5610 in 2007. About 16,000 students committed suicide in the last 3 decades, and there are some cases that are still unsolved. This one important decision that our parents have to take is of our marriage, but our parents are blind to the social norms and custom prevailing in India. They do not allow us for intercaste marriages. Yes, they do not allow us for intercaste marriages. And if a child who agrees to it, sometimes it has to face honor killing. Every parent wants his child to give a good life. Yes, and every parent wants to give a good life to his child. But these mentioned situations makes us realize that our parents are not always right. It's ridiculous to understand the honor of those parents. It's ridiculous to understand the honor of those parents who killed their child for honor killing. Now I want to put a question in this assembly. How many of you had never committed any mistake? Anyone? First, parents are humans. Humans made mistakes. And somebody has rightly said, if somebody has never made a mistake in their life, they have never tried a new thing in their life. I repeat, if somebody has never tried a new, has never committed any mistake in their life, they have never tried a new thing in their life. I hope you all are convinced. And if my body opinions are still not convinced, then I want them to put it on Google. And you'll find hundreds of pages with thousands of parents admitting it. That yes, they were wrong at certain points of time. After all, they are human. They own their parents. Thank you.
Life is too short to make up with regrets. So love the people who loves you, who cares for you, who supports you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I, Anjali Saini, is here to speak on the topic, Are Parents Always Right? And I'm for the motion. It's true that no one in the world is always correct. But do not take the literal meaning of the words. This is just allow some human errors, because to err is human. But do not ignore the fact that we are a part of them. We are a part of our parents, and they are our relatives. They might not surrender to all our wishes, not because they are against us, but because they are experienced at times. They are much more wiseable, much more knowledgeable, and much more intelligent, and have experienced the good things, the bad things, and faced whatever challenges we are going to face in our life. Our parents believe that their children deserve better education, best schools. That's why they enroll us in good education, good institutes. They want that their children get better education. They prepare us for future. Our children have short attention span. So like any loving parents, they decide what's good, what's bad for us. They have been through what is good or what is bad. They are always proud of us. They want their child to achieve their own dream. This sacrifices their important and social time to be with us. They allow us to have a break. They believe that their child should learn what is important for him in his life. As far as experience is concerned, they are much more superior to us. It's safer to assume that they are always right. As my friend, I have seen an alcoholic drug addict becoming an NGO person because of his father, because of his parents, because of their support. friend, my opponent, to disagree with me, as long as he understands that I'm right and he's wrong. But the question arises, why do we fail at a certain level of our life to understand our parents? Why their concern, their love, becomes an interference for us? It is just because till the age of 18, we never thought that our parents are wrong. But abruptly, when we cross the mark of 18, we start thinking that our parents are our enemies. It's not true. At the end of this discussion, I would like to conclude that criticism is always dishonest. We are the one who supports this. So I would like to say that we should that our parents are always right, and we should also support them. Thank you.
In the 18 years of my childhood, I have experienced a lot of love and affection that my parents have towards me. But there were some instances in which I and my parents didn't stand together, which made it a huge difference between us and our lifetimes. In these 18 years, I have experienced so much of the feelings of every child sitting here, so that I, Akshay Manivar, can stand here in front of you all and speak against the topic that parents are always right. Parents are humans, and humans tend to do mistakes. So it won't be wrong if we say that parents also commit mistakes, which means that they are not always right. I agree that parents are superior to us and have much more experience, but it doesn't mean that they are always right. We need to accept their every suggestion as an order, but sometimes it's just not accepted. What may be acceptable to us may be not even bearable for them. Suppose there is a friend of mine of opposite sex, and she is in need of an accommodation, and I do have a spare room in my house, and as a friend, it's my duty to help her, but my parents will definitely not allow her to stay with us, as she is of opposite sex. Who is to be blamed in this situation? Are my parents right? Shall I just accept the order and just let it be? I don't think so. I need to help my friends and tell them, my parents, that you are wrong this time, and you need to accept this fact. When I was choosing my career, when I was choosing my subject in class 11, I would have taken science and would have been a dropout in 11th and 12th, but I chose commerce and performed quite well in my first course. I went against my parents' wishes and chose a subject in which was I interested in. But I have seen many people who surrender against their parents' wishes and in the end ruin their career. Having said so much and citing a few examples from my own personal life, I still stand against the motion. We all need to accept the fact that there is a generation gap between us and our parents, and there has been a huge change in the time today and the time they graduate. Be it education, course guidance, technology, or the way we decorate our thoughts, it's always better to accept the change. And if not accepted, one is bound to commit mistakes. And I'm sorry to say, but same happens with our parents. So with all due respect to our parents, in the end, I would like to say that you are also an human, and therefore cannot be right always.
Parents are the roots from which we rise. Parents are the goal from which we shine. Parents provide us the strength to fight. Parents provide us the love to survive. Parents provide us the freedom to fly like a kite. I, Himanshu Khanna, would like to take this platform to support my opinion. Parents are always right. Parents are always right. With full regards to all my counterparts who are here with their realistic reasons and clauses to strongly argue that parents being another human being are not right always. But my dear friends, if human beings are not right always, then how come our parents were right when we have no decision power and all the decisions were taken by parents? Parents are humans too, undoubtedly, because humans are the emotional creatures of God who have the feelings to love their child and make best decisions for them. My dear friends, even an animal loves his child and tries to protect him from any kind of harm. But this does not imply that a bird would not teach his child to fly with the fear that he would fall down. Similarly, if our parents were right when they thought that we should lean their hands so that we could fall down, get up and learn to walk by ourselves, and I fail to understand why we think that our parents are not right in today's time to take our decisions. Another issue that raises the question of parents' credibility is that kids nowadays are technology savvy, an area where most of the middle class parents may lag behind. But remember, my friends, it was only our father or mother who encouraged us to learn this technology and supported us and bought us our first laptop, our first mobile, our first iPhone, or any other gadget we hold mastery on. Every parent has his own way of raising their child, which affects by his own family background, family environment and culture. Many of you may object this, that this makes our parents more possessive and overprotective. But friends, please tell, which society dismisses the fact that the children should not be trained in their own culture? If we are not trained in our own culture, then we are incomplete as a human being. And who can best tell us about our culture rather than our parents? Another point which I would like to put forward in today's discussion is that a parent, whether rich or poor, always prioritizes his child's wishes, dreams and demands over his own. Last but not the least, the main reason why we are discussing this is that most of us feel that once we grow up, our parents tend to take our career decisions. But my dear friends, I would like to take this guarantee that if you would talk to your parents and you know what you want and you have that capability, then I'm sure your parent, which was earlier telling you to take an alternate career, would definitely take your consideration once you show the determination. Parents may set rules, but they are not wrong. And you all may like to call me a mother's boy, but I would like to accept this with full pride, because nevertheless, we are not perfect, but the main discussion is that parents are always right. Thank you.
Good morning. Everybody present over here knows about an Indian saying, Mata Pita Ke Charno Mein Swarg. Now, which swarg are we talking about here? Is it the one where our parents send us by imposing their expectations and restrictions? Or is it the one where the parents sell their girl child? There is a popular Indian word called Jugaad. Jugaad is still very much an Indian obsession, as the frantic, embarrassing, shameful acts are being run by some of the parents. My heart literally cries when I see the filthy state of the street children collecting food from the garbage. Whose fault is this? It is the fault of their parents who have given birth to these children without thinking. I am totally shocked to see that some of the parents teach their children how to murder, how to cheat. How to murder and how to cheat. Parents do not allow their children to go on outings or to disco. Now, if you are imposing such sort of restrictions upon them, then they will be tempted to do this thing even more. Remember, a girl wearing a ghagra choli is much more clever and witty than a girl wearing a mini skirt. We all know about the HIV advertisement that comes on television. Whenever the advertisement comes, the parents change the channel. Why? Actually, they are digging a pit for their children from where there is no escaping out. It is these parents, which teach their children about the various social evils present in our society. They teach them about the caste system, and yeah, who can forget about the Kundli system? which are matched when we get married. We are living in 21st century and you are matching kundalis. Strange. Parents tell their children not to touch their mate. It is a blot, a slur on the face of our society. Parents, on their own go on outings, but do not allow their children to go on outings, which is like putting salt on the already burnt wounds of the students. Whenever I take the name of Pakistan, the very first thing that comes in your mind is, Pakistan are enemies. Parents, stop growing the seeds of enmity in your children's mind. Why do you take such stringent measures when your child does a mistake? A teaching with a smile has broader impact than a stick in your hand. Have you ever thought about the child whose father comes home drunk and beats his mother? Have you ever thought about the child who does not get time of his parents and finally he gets into depression? My partner says that parents are always right. When are they right? When they give birth to these flowers and then they just throw them away somewhere? It is high time, children. We have to wake up. We cannot take the decisions that are not fruitful for us. Parents are also humans. Parents also do make mistakes. Steel can be cut with steel. Similarly, we have to guard ourselves from the false decisions of our parents. Do not let these flowers yet wither away. Let the buds blossom. Save childhood, save humanity. Thank you.
Namaskar to one and all. I am Adarsh Shukla speaking for the motion that parents are always right. First of all, we need to make a clear understanding what the topic exactly is. We need to understand the spirit behind the topic. We need not to go by the words strictly that it says always, it says parents, it says right always and all that stuff. Next thing I want to say that let's just move ahead of Google and Wikipedia debating. Let's just move ahead of ghagra, choli, skirt and all stuff. Let's just concentrate on hardcore debating. I'll start up my arguments before deciding who is right, who is wrong, let's just check out what are the intentions. When a guardian decides something on behalf of his children, on behalf of his child, what exactly his intentions are. I believe no one will doubt his intentions that are simply the best in the world. So something is really, he is doing with the best possible intentions. Now we need to differentiate. The debate is all about two ways. Number one way is of child's way and the second way is of parents' way. We are here to just show some light that which way goes, which way is a better way and we should choose which way. And I am here to support the motion that yes, the way that our parents suggest us is much more better, much more stable than the way that we choose. I'll start off with my first point. Just take a common example of pocket money. Most of the children are really unsatisfied of their pocket money. They even think that they are even not getting the minimum what should they get. And it's not sufficient for them. But their parents have a crystal clear idea that what amount of money should be given to his child. Because suppose you have started smoking recently and you have a damn sure belief that smoking 13 to 15 cigarettes daily is really needful, is really important for you. But is it important in the eyes of your parents? According to them, smoking a single cigarette is also not permissible, is objectionable. So we need to think that what exactly the better way is. My second argument will be based on the ground of experience. We should, my worthy opponent said that, yeah, let this child experience, let this child fail, let this child learn and all that stuff. I'm just saying you, I'm just suggesting you that if your parents has lots of, you know, useful experience, why not to use it? Why to waste time? Why to just get, why to just fail and fail again and then learn? You should learn with your father's, your mother's experience. So experience is a big factor. You, a child or a youth decides anything with quite, you know, he decides instantly something. He makes a frame, at the very next moment he breaks the frame, and after that he makes a new frame. This is how a youth or a child or a youth's mind works. But parents have a crystal clear idea that what impact, what short term impact this particular thing is gonna do on this child, what long term impact this particular thing gonna they do on this child. My next argument is, some of my opponents said that parents are unaware with the process of change. I find this argument quite baseless. In fact, parents have the process of change has come to you by your parents. They have witnessed the process of change quite clearly. They have witnessed the process of change quite maturely, quite gradually. So you need to understand. And some of my opponents, I don't know, it was with, even I really find it quite ridiculous when you say that infanticide like issues and killing child and all that honor killing stuff. Guys, these all are crime. These are not violation of child's right. These are violation of law. And from any platform, I'm damn sure that no one can justify crimes even if it is done by parents or child. Ultimately, we need to understand that we are here to find some solution. We are not here in a boxing ring that after whole the process of debating will raise someone's hand and will say that yes, parents are winner or children are winner. So we need to understand that we are here to find a better way. Which way is a better way? I believe that no one is perfect, but we have to find that who is better and which way we should follow. Parents should be more compromising. From here I rest my case. Thanks a lot.
Hello.